At Thales, we design as well as manufacture our own authenticators. This is true for PKI, it's true for FIDO, and it's also true for OTP, or one-time password authenticators, such as these ones right here. So here I have a stack of OTP 110 authenticators. And we actually bundle these free of charge with our own access management solution called SafeNet Trusted Access. But we do also occasionally sell these for third-party use, and one such third party is Microsoft Azure. To get these to work with Azure, and that's exactly what I'm going to show you today, to get these to work with Azure, we need to get the secret with which each and every individual authenticator has been programmed. We need to get that secret into Azure. In the industry, there's a standardized protocol or format for doing this. But Microsoft, being Microsoft, they require this to be in a CSV file, so a clear text file. And so what we're going to do is we're going to take the CSV file as output by Thales for third-party use, and we're going to reformat that for Microsoft-specific requirements. I will show you how to do that. I will show you how to do that programmatically. And then I will also show you how to import into Azure, how to activate MFA for users, how to activate MFA for Office 365, and then I'll show you how to log in to Office 365 using one-time passwords as generated by one of these authenticators. If we flip this, look at the back side. Apart from me having printed the test username here, and you should not do that for production, obviously, we can see that there's a serial number. So we have 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, and so on and so forth. So they are actually ordered inside of this stack. Now, to make distribution, handing these out to individual users in our population, what I want to do with the seed file is I want to reorder that as well so they match my physical stack of tokens as well.
Working from the generic seed file in CSV format, the first thing you notice is that there's a header row or a heading row, if you like, and then we have a number of authenticator records here, 10 in total in this case. And then examining each column, starting with the serial number column, and if I could just bring your attention to the last two digits here, you see 29, 30, and then 34. So this is what I was talking about earlier. I'd like to sort this so you have 29, 30, 31. Next, you have the secret key column. And again, this contains the individual secret of each authenticator, and this is in base 32 format. What follows then is manufacturer as well as model. And looking at the manufacturer column, says GA. And GA is actually short for Gemalto, which was acquired by Thales a while back. So I'd like to update this value because in Azure you have visibility of this attribute. So it should say Thales. And the same thing goes for model. LT is short for Lava Time, which is a product name we use in a different business unit. This should instead say OTP 110. Next we have start date, and interestingly this is not used by Microsoft at all. Instead, Microsoft has an activation procedure that I'll show you shortly. So this column needs to go away. I need to remove this entirely. And then we have time interval 30. So that's a 30 second interval with which a one-time password is generated. Microsoft also requires you to add a column called UPN, or user principal name. So that needs to be added for this to work. Looking at Visual Studio Code here, I've crafted a little bit of a script, and it will filter for CSV, allow you to browse to a CSV source file, import that by column, adding the UPN columns, and then the relevant columns that Microsoft requires. It will then sort on the serial number column, so that will take care of the ordering. And finally, it will replace GA with Thales on the manufacturer and LT with OTP 110 for the model. Let's run this and see the results. So it prompts me to proceed. It informs me of the actions to be carried out. Press Y for yes and browse to the seed file as you saw earlier. And now the script is actually done and we can go ahead and have a look at the results. So reload the file. First thing we notice is that we now have a UPN column. It's empty, but still. And then you see on the serial number 29, 30, 31, and so on. So it's now in order. Time interval has been shifted a little bit inwards, and then manufacturer and model has been updated, Thales and OTP 110. So for my demo now, I'm gonna use just a single user. So take away a bunch of these, and then I'm gonna go ahead and input the user principal name here. From here, let's go into Azure portal. And what you need to do is find multi-factor authentication. There are different ways of doing that. In my case, I've used it before, so it's on my homepage, if you will. If not, what you can do is use the center top search bar and just start typing. It will filter for that service. From here, the first thing I want to do is kind of like set the baseline for this to guide the user experience. And typically what I do and what I suggest is you deselect as much as possible. So deselect call to phone, deselect text message that's not secure, and make sure we streamline the user experience. So just the hardware token there, and we save that and close. So now we have the baseline. Turning to Office 365 active users, and we see Alice Smith. She's an existing user. If you look top center, you see multi-factor authentication. Press that, and there's different ways of doing this. Since I'm modifying a single user, I could just filter for that user, click enable and confirm, and that enables multi-factor. If you're working with multiple users, let me just revert this. Okay, if you're working from multiple users, what you can do is use the bulk update feature. This requires a CSV file, and it's actually a different CSV file. It looks something like this. I'll show you in a sec here. Okay, so it has two columns, username and MFA status. Status can be enabled or disabled, just like in the GUI there. And you could run an API call to get the list of users and then modify that with either the value enabled or disabled. So something like this. Anyways, okay, let me do a bulk update. Granted, it's still a single user. Okay, that's successful, okay. And now MFA is enabled for Alice. Turn back to Azure portal. And I'm in a sub menu now called Oath Tokens, Open Authentication Tokens. From here, we can upload the seed file as modified earlier. So click upload, select the modified seed file. And this page doesn't seem to refresh by itself, so you might have to press refresh once or twice here. There we go. You see Alice Smith, you see the token serial number 29, the model, the make, and pressing activate and then getting that specific authenticator, pressing it, generating a passcode, and this will have Microsoft validate the authenticator is working and everything is in sync with the server. And it now changed to activated. You see the checkbox. Let's look at this in action now, logging into Office or Microsoft as Alice. So sign in, provide username. Provide, in this case, Active Directory password. And it then prompts for the passcode from the token. So press the token, generate a passcode 16504. 16504, hit enter, click verify. That logs you in. So that's it.